Alright, we,
If only it had a front door. By the way, Grant, I'm gonna keep a tally of every time you drop your accent, and you're gonna lose that many DKP.
That's okay.
Cause I'm bringing it back.
I'm trying to stop my face right now.
That's cool.
Whenever we do leave the tower, I'm gonna pack it up, take it with me.
Okay. Are you guys heading out then?
I suppose.
I think we're good.
Just so I say it, I'm gonna plus one my armor with my cleric feature.
Okay. That is, you do that once per long rest, is that correct?
Yep.
Okay.
I can change it once per long rest, or it stays consistent.
Okie dokie.
It's weird, its duration isn't a day, it's until I take a long rest, so...
Okay. So you all plus Stool and Dawnbringer, I'll head out. Nothing has come to this cave. There's no additional creatures or anything like that. It was a pretty quiet night, and as far as you guys know, I mean, you guys were inside the windowless section.
I used Thunderclap.
Marking that down. For real? Okay.
Sure, why not?
What is that?
It's aggro stuff. No, it's just loud.
You guys hear especially in this cave where it's very, very echoey, what sounds like lightning hitting like 10 feet away.
Sorry, I guess. People within 5 feet of me take a constitution saving throw. Whoops.
Why don't everybody make a constitution saving throw?
Yep.
This is loud as
fuck. There was one.
That's 1d6 on a fail save.
You guys get the plus 5 from...
No, well, Fossil still doesn't save. So he's gonna be deaf. Roll for tonight is save.
I guess 26. That's,
Constitution again?
I rolled a mop.
Wow, well, close. Is everybody really five around? Is everybody really just surrounding me all touching my butt?
Plus four?
Yeah. I'm just doing this for shits and giggles. Why not? And I'm going to roll for Stool, who has a -2 constitution modifier.
You son of a bitch.
Natural 20. Stool's the best. And Dawnbringer?
He has no ears. How are you going to...
Dawnbringer, yeah, he basically... What's your spell save, DC?
17.
Okay. So, Brightwood, Fossilis. Oops.
Sorry, guys. I am the asshole. I didn't even realize. Shun. I thought it was just a cantrip.
Didn't we tell you last night to be quiet?
Damn.
You just let off the loudest fart I ever heard in my life.
And you guys take 12 damage, people who failed.
Sorry. Well, I'm an ass.
Ma!
Okay.
Can anyone read his lips?
Hey, I was just trying to draw out some more Minotaurs.
What?
Minotaurs!
What?
For the sake of time, this goes on for an hour. We'll say it's...
So,
it wears off.
So, from where we're standing, we can continue going up or go back to that?
There's no other way up. This is the dead end.
End of this one.
Well, there is a cliff that goes straight down and you can't see the bottom that this tower was on the end of. But no other tunnels in this section.
We don't like bottomless pits, so we're gonna go back to the intersection there.
Okay, who's leading?
I'll try and find the way back.
Yeah, make a survival check with disadvantage. Or do you have advantage down here because this is your favorite terrain?
It is.
So just a flat roll.
14.
14? Okay.
Which sucks because it double triple clicked it apparently. Not 20.
So you guys don't have your trail of coins was picked up by the Minotaurs that you guys called with the previous thunderclap. So you don't really have too much information way back. You can see some landmarks, so you get to a couple of the forks, and you know, okay, we definitely didn't go down those because of the way they're angled. But you get to another, about 10 minutes of walking, you get to another fork, and you can't remember which one of these four pathways to go down. So you can make another survival check.
Okay. 25.
Okay. So you instinctively start, like, heading to the one on the far right when you realize you look down and you kind of see that there's, like, a dust on the ground and there's no footprints on the dust in that tunnel, so you know that's not it. And then so you're checking now for footprints, and you do see a little bit of tracks from your group before and manage to go down the right path, which another 10-15 minutes of walking, you guys are back out of the large dome that is the entrance, the many entrances to the maze, and you walk out, and to your left is the cave that has the torches and the lights on it, and there's many, many more caves going in both directions, right and left.
Does the only illuminated path with all the torches, does it look fairly well traveled?
Make an investigation check.
10.
No more well traveled than the one you've been through.
And that goes down, if I remember right.
That one goes down. The one you guys went on went up. Yep. The one directly to your right seems to be on a flat surface. It does not slant any way. And you don't know the ones beyond those.
Do you sense any people around?
I suppose if you give me a minute, I could try to see if there are any other people around.
And any of your paladins feeling anything evil?
So yeah, I'll concentrate for a minute. Primeval awareness on humanoids.
Okay. And it's within 6 miles?
Yes.
Hundreds.
All kind of like just evenly scattered throughout?
Yeah, some within... there's some that are like straight down. There's some that are... kind of off to your left, all varying distances between a mile and 6 miles.
Can I spend another minute and see if there are any fiends?
Any what?
Fiends?
Fiends.
Yes.
I don't know, I have to check. Any fiends?
There seem to be a whole lot of people around. Maybe lost souls, maybe a roving group of musical lyricists, perhaps.
No fiends.
There's no evil things down here, though. Maybe evil, but there's no big, scary evil things.
Well, that doesn't sound too bad.
Might be some kind of evil things, but there's no demons.
Well, you're the tracker. So,
can't really track what I don't know what I'm looking for. I'll be honest with you.
Okay.
Wow. We could take the other door. Kind of feel like the lights might be a trap, or it could be the maze messing with us, and it could be salvation. I don't really know.
I say follow the light.
You want to follow the light?
Indeed.
Well, if I hear no nays, then I believe that'll be the way we'll be taken. And if you'd kindly follow behind me, tree trunks, to keep me safe, I'd really appreciate your comfort. I mean, company. Company, sir. A little bit of a Freudian slip there.
Hello, Joseph. Hello. You guys have not gone anywhere, Joseph, except for you managed to make it out of the tunnel you guys went down last time, and you're back at the entrance deciding where to go. I believe the vote has been for the lit tunnel.
Cool. It's two to five people haven't answered.
Yeah, I'm down for the lit tunnel.
Fucking lit.
Just gonna unmuting to say that, you ass.
I just joined now, but I'm also down for that.
Tunnel. Okay. I guess Fossil's make a survival check, please, if you guys are going down there. And are you guys leaving a trail of coins again?
Do we have any chalk or maybe some charcoal, perhaps, to try to write on the walls instead of leaving behind a valuable trail that might get picked up?
I could mold earth as we go and make marks in the ground or walls.
That's a great idea.
Ah, brilliant, brilliant.
How often are you doing that?
Let's do it every, 100, 150 feet or so.
Okay. And it's just a cantrip, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it'll be a little arrow pointing in the direction we went.
Okay. Wait.
It's going to be in a script that only people I've taught the script to can understand it.
Okay. Which is you.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we need you. This is very
yeah, this is called insurance.
But then nothing can follow us either.
Okay. So you guys
perhaps whisper what the rune is to me.
Maybe next time we rest I can teach you a thing or two about cryptology.
Sounds terrifying, but I'm down.
Hopefully the guy with limited memory capabilities can remember what he's writing down.
But that's arcana, this is.
Oh, right. So you guys walk, you guys probably walk about a mile. And there's no offshoots on this. It's been a steady decline until you get to a three-way fork, again, kind of like the one you guys saw in the other passage. They don't look any different from each other, but there are three directions.
Are they all lit up?
None of them are lit up. There's phosphorescent lichen everywhere. But the only lights were at the entrance to this. The only torches were at the entrance to this this tunnel.
Okay.
I suppose I would have a bow or something, just to see.
Well, I mean, you can see. It's dim.
What direction does the glorious leader point us towards? Or perhaps...
I just point north, and I try to sense which way is north.
Okay, how are you doing that?
Channeling my inner deity.
got bullshit better than that, boy.
Looking for me father's guidance.
Looking for, yes.
Roll charisma check, I guess.
Charisma?
Yep.
Fifteen?
You think North is, directly behind you.
Can I do an insight check?
That way!
Sure,
can I point behind us?
You both have no idea what each other are talking about. Fossus, can you make a perception check, please?
Sure. Nat 20.
Okay. You're looking around, you guys are all trying to figure out which way to go, and you're kind of scanning the area to see which place is safer as a ranger does. And you notice at the back of the group, you see Brightwood casting a spell.
What are you doing?
Are you going through with it?
Yeah.
Out of nowhere, Fossless, you can sense everything within 120 feet. Your vision changes. The darkness does not affect you. It's not like you're seeing with your eyes. It's like you're sensing everything that's there. And you can see footprints that were long past on the ground. And you can see little wisps that float by that almost don't look real. And you have clarity in your vision that you've never had before.
I don't know what you did to me, but this is the best high I've ever had in my life. This is amazing. This is wonderful. I know everything.
You effectively have true sight right now.
Ooh, dope. Cool. Hey, Grico, you might want to get that thing on your lip checked. It's looking a little bit red.
Yeah,
I can see through the mask. I gotta tell you, you're a lot prettier than
this
I remember.
This is the first time you've seen his face.
You're a gorgeous, beautiful man. I gotta tell you. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. But I can understand why you wear the mask.
I'm blushing underneath the mask.
So on the ground, you can see, now that you have this ability, you can see hoof marks coming through the far left route, and then heading back out the way that you guys just came. That seems to be heavily traveled with hoof marks. The other two directions are very lightly traveled, if at all.
Would I recognize them as Minotaur tracks?
Make a nature check.
Not 20.
Yeah, you do. Those are Minotaur tracks.
Looks like the big harney fellas came from our hair.
Do they keep any sort of treasure troves?
I don't really know. Do I know anything about
Minotaurs? I mean, they do keep treasure in, like, their towns and stuff, but they're not, like, animalistic beasts that have, like, a horde. They're so intelligent.
Relatively intelligent.
Probably more so than relatively. Like, there is intelligence to any... They're way more intelligent than you are in a maze, that's for sure. Because you know Minotaurs do not get lost.
We should go ask one for help.
Well, the last two that we saw kind of attacked us on sight, so I don't know if they'll be being a bit friendly.
Well, we just have to beat it to an inch of its life and then persuade it to help us.
Every time we try to do that, we end up overkilling it and murdered in a blaze of glory. He just ends up bleeding out or missing a leg or...
Well, this time's different, okay? I believe in us.
The pyramid guy that's with you guys starts to spin and look down every single path and goes, please proceed further. Cannot calculate direction.
Well, we've got, it appears to be two untraveled paths down with horrors unbeknownst to us awaiting. Or we could go murder some Minotaurs. I don't know if I'm against unabashed horror, but we could always take our chances.
I'm okay with following the well-traveled route.
Well, the Minotaur tracks, they probably know where they're going. So maybe we should follow them?
Ah, appears so.
You really think Minotaurs are keen on hanging out with some random shield? I think it's a long-lost relic in a long-lost place. And we should venture maybe into the unknown.
Well,
that's also a good point.
A renowned poet from the area I grew up always said it was best to take the road less traveled. His name was Robert Frost, I believe.
Get out.
I believe I heard the same poem credited to a Bob Cold.
Great half of the poems. Holy shit. Bob Cold. I'm gonna write that one down for later. Anywho, where would you guys like to go?
Well, I'd be okay with going to the road less traveled too.
So.
Yes.
How does find a path work in this scenario?
Let me take a look.
In the fuck you, it's a goddamn maze. God damn it.
Find the path.
This spell allows you to find the shortest, most direct physical route to a specific fixed location that you're familiar with on the same plane of existence.
You have to be familiar with the location, though.
But I saw that I'm kind of familiar with the shield.
Oh, yeah, fair enough.
Because of the vision from the crystally place.
You are familiar with the shield.
So,
did you take this spell just for the maze?
Oh, I've had it for like 3 days, yeah. The last couple sessions, I've been waiting for it.
Alright,
well, fuck it. I cast, find the path, I guess.
Okay. You know that the area with the shield is approximately 40 miles away. It is leading you down the pathway down in which the Minotaurs came from.
Okay. I will convey this information to the party. So it looks like the Minotaurs came from where we should go. I think that's the shortest path.
All right.
Well, how do I know I can trust you, hmm?
I just give you the crazy eyes and big smile. Teeth missing.
All right. I suppose we're going down the path. Well traveled.
Are you staying in the front, Fossils?
If El Greco wants to come next to me to help guide me,
don't want to get ambushed and hit while I'm concentrating on this spell.
All right, I'll take the lead.
I will hang out in the middle.
I can see your true intentions. Oh, I should have said true color. God damn. Musical moment lost. I'll take the lead.
Okay. What pace are you guys traveling at? You guys try to go fast? Normal. Are you going stealthily? Are you going normal?
We can travel at a normal pace.
You have absolutely no penalties to perception with tree seeing up for the next hour at least.
Nope. Brisk walk.
Okay. So you continue following your find the path route, and it's been about 40 more minutes that you guys have been walking, and there have been a couple offshoot paths, but using the spell, you know, to stay or to turn off on certain ones. Right before the hour's up on your true sight, you get to another fork, and this time at the end of both of the tunnels that fork off, two out of the four, my apologies, you can actually see the end of the tunnels in these ones. They don't go on and on and on. They're actual ends to the two tunnels. However, the find the path is not sending you down either one of those. It's sending you down one of the other two that you cannot see the end of. And that's right about when your true seeing wears out. Or is wearing out.
Okay. Can I tell if which is it going to the left or the right to follow the path?
There is one on the left that you could see the end of, and you can kind of see kind of a pillar in the center and something glowing on the ground. And then there's a tunnel on its right that you cannot see the end of, that the find the path is telling you to go down there. There's one to the right of that, which you would see the end of, and you can kind of see a little pedestal with some sort of shiny object on it. And you can see the end of that one. And then there's one on the far right that you can't see the end of, that find the path not telling you to go down.
But it is clearly telling me to go down.
It's clearly telling you to go down the second from the left. Well, it's telling you to go Vegro. But you can see the end of these other two tunnels. They cannot.
Okay. Well, I might as well follow the path, see where it leads. I'll convey that the... So, I can see the end.
Okay.
A little column in the middle and a little glowy light. I want a statuette.
Okay.
A statuette might be a little bit dangerous.
Could also be powerful. Powerful magic item.
Could also be a large rolling boulder that will crush us to our to an early demise, but
this is Indiana Jones.
Yeah. Also Yu-Gi-Oh.
Well, I'm sure we have ways to avoid being crushed by a boulder.
Well, perhaps, but that's not the way that,
True Seeing wears out right now.
Oh. Can I get it again? I really liked it.
Not for a while.
Oh, but please. The world's a lot more gray now. I feel cold.
Where do you guys want to go?
It's up to you guys.
Well, I could stay here and wait while you guys go check that out. Or, well, I guess it doesn't really matter. I can always find the path back.
Yeah, if you're concentrating, you're concentrating for 24 hours.
Yeah.
Tricky can put a mark down too.
Yeah. Well, we might as well put a mark down in the direction of the path that we should be following just in case. And let's go check out these other areas.
Alrighty. I'm down for that.
RPG strats, check every corner.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't know what an RPG is, but might as well check it out.
So which way are you going down?
Rule of lefts, guys.
Sure.
Yeah.
Lefts.
Yep.
It's the one with the pillar at the end. All at the bottom.
Living loose.
Okay. With a glow at the bottom. So you guys walk in there and you can see there's a pillar that has a moon, a star, a flame, and a boulder. Kind of like a child's maze game on it, carved on it vertically. And there is a large pink glowing sigil on the ground in front of it.
Can I investigate the star?
Sure.
I got 3.
Three? It's a pretty star. Are you touching it?
Well, I probably would have handled it at some point, or at least, you know, rub my fingers over it, so yeah.
It's me every night.
Okay, so you guys watch as Shashun walks up and he's kind of investigating, and he touches the star, and you see the pink rune light up, and Shashun vanishes.
Can I take a look at this rune?
Sure, make an arcana check.
Oh god. It's magical. It's beautiful. It's wonderful.
Tell me what your score is.
Two. It's two.
It's pretty glowy. It's nice and pink.
Oh, it's nice and pretty. Shoshone, are you in here? Where did you go?
So there's a star, a moon, a flame.
A child's maze.
And it was the moon that lit up when he touched the star?
Nope, the rune. The rune on the ground lit up.
I will go touch the moon.
Shushun! You guys, I believe he's missing. I can't see him, I can't hear him. He's not in here.
Does anything happen when he fishes?
Tears a big lady boy! I'm gonna look around and see if Dawnbringer heard me.
Sorry, say what you said again, Fossils.
I was just calling out Shashun's name. I said, "Tears a big lady boy." And then I was going to look around to see if Dawnbringer heard me, because I forgot he was in the room when I said it.
Well, maybe should we have Treekey check these out for someone who knows something about the magical stuff?
Whoa.
I guess you'd do alright too.
Wait, my bad. I thought Crux was calling me something else.
Yeah, no, sorry. The original one. Not the original one, the first one that you went through. You guys watch as Shashun pops back right next to the pillar that he touched. I made a mistake with the second one, by the way. I thought you wrote the moon, but that's my bad.
Okay.
He is very distinctly out of breath.
Oh my god, yes.
Where'd you run off to?
You that hard.
There was no air where I was at. It was a little scary. You guys might want to prepare yourselves when you touch them.
Why would we touch them?
I don't know, but
you should just touch them all for us.
Where did you go?
It was a pretty scary place. I was floating on an island amongst the stars, and I had no air to breathe.
Only Roland would have liked
that place.
Aw, oh, damn, this would be the perfect time for breath-holding octopus.
You guys do have a necklace of adaptation.
Yeah, we do have a necklace. I believe it's on
I have a necklace of adaptation.
Tree.
I have a necklace of adaptation, but I don't want to touch any of these statues.
You said it was an island on the, surrounded by stars?
Correct.
Could I perhaps borrow the necklace?
Can I do a history check to see if I've ever heard of something like that?
Sure.
I guess you could have my necklace.
History or Arcana, it's your choice.
Whatever. I rolled history. They're the same score, so.
Can I try to attune to the necklace of adaptation?
You'll have to spend 10 minutes waiting here, but you can.
Okay, I'll take off my cloak of Elvenkind.
Okay.
No, I'm gonna take off my braces of archery for a moment.
Okay. You can keep them on. You're just not attuned to them, so.
Oh, okay. Then.
You don't actually have to physically take them off.
Okay. Cool.
You should take them off.
Take it all off.
It sounds like.
Dirty girl.
It sounds like a. What you think it is another plane of existence. Which one you're not sure. That's what it sounds like to you.
Okay.
So you spend the 10 minutes to get attuned to it.
Can I touch the star rune that I saw?
Is everybody else is standing away from the rune, I take it?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
You touch the star. You are transported, and you do appear on a just a piece of land floating in what looks just to be what looks like the night sky. But the stars aren't. Now that you're not gasping and panicking, you can actually like take a look around and everything. Make a perception check.
Doop 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 doop. 26.
26. You can see the stars aren't necessarily massive stars really far away, but little floating lights everywhere. And you see a bunch of just random stuff floating around. You see just a bunch of gems and you see a bunch of gold. You see a chest floating around you in the air, and it's fairly small. There's some jewelry. It does look like a small Zirkwood chest.
Do I recognize
this
anything
time,
else that's
make
during
a
this time? And the 10 minutes we were waiting for attunement, can I take the paladins aside and teach them the code I'm using on the walls?
Sure, you guys can all make intelligence checks.
Can I learn it too?
No.
Oh.
I'm not learning that shit.
make an investigation check, Fossilis.
Totally gonna do that.
26.
9.
You recognize a lot of things in here.
Could they be perhaps the things that I'm...
They look like a lot of your things, specifically, yes.
Does Shun want to make an intelligence check?
Okay.
Craig, make a arcana check.
I got it. It's not gonna be good. It's a 16.
I mean, with your other rolls are pretty high. You don't know for sure, but you're fairly confident you're in the astral plane, which is the plane where everything that's put into a bag of holding exists.
Yeah, I kind of thought so. Oh!
And you are currently looking at the island that stores all your stuff.
Okay, that's neat.
Craig, did you go like there with your bag of holding?
What? shut up, Jet. Yeah. Yep. I got the bag of holding on my person.
It is still there.
Okay.
Okay.
That's what I'm super mad about. I wonder if, like, put your hand in the bag and, like, can you poke yourself? Big hand comes down from the skies.
Was it a nice island? Is it...
It's a little grassy piece of rock.
This time on Krugs of the Abyss, Faustulus gets high on life.
I really, would I know better than to open the bag?
Make an intelligence check.
I really doubt I would. 15.
I'll leave it up to you.
Okay. I'm probably not going to. If I was going to roll below a 12, I would have. Would have put Roland in the bag, but they're not real stars, so I'm gonna float around a little bit, see if I can find like a door. Get out.
You're not floating.
Oh.
You're actually physically on this island. There's gravity.
I thought it was like okay.
No. Cool. You're on the island. The island is floating. You see on the island there is a pillar like the one you saw with the same four symbols and the rune there as well.
Try to touch the star?
You do not move.
Oh, I can't move?
No, you touch the star and nothing happens.
I'm scared. I'm gonna touch the moon.
The moon? You are instantly teleported into a large field. There are large trees everywhere. There's a big pool of water in front of you. There's a bunch of kind of strange-looking deer looking at you. They're just kind of grazing there, and then you just appear out of nowhere.
Is the pillar still there?
The pillar's still there. Circle's still there.
Can I take a better look at my surroundings?
Sure. As far as you can see, you are in a vast forest. There are a couple birds, there are some deer, but they don't look like anything you've ever seen before.
Kind of like mutant animals, or like...
Mutant would be a way to describe them, I guess. It's a very, very peaceful place.
I might want to spend the rest of my days here. It's quite lovely. I'm gonna try to hit the star again.
You are back in the astral plane.
Okay, I'm gonna touch the flame.
Flame? You are teleported again. This time it is pitch black. There's a little bit of white light surrounding you. But other than that, you can't see anything. And you can't see the pillar. And then you see little flames start to burst onto the ground. Until the entire ground, except for this little white space that you are in, is all burning. And you can see the pillar about 20 feet away from you. And you hear a voice go, "Why did you come here?"
Oh, I was looking for a place to spend the rest of my days.
This is one place where people spend the rest of their days.
I'd like to go to the nice field, though. It was quite pleasant there.
That's what they usually say.
You can't hardly say
and
the
you,
name.
And you see a humanoid start walking toward you through the fire. About as tall as a normal human. He's in long red robes. He's got a large staff in his hand. His skin is bright red. He has four sets of horns on his head. His eyes are completely black. And he just says, "Usually when people come here, they do not do so willingly. You are here to give yourself to me."
Well, I suppose we could have a meal together first, but it's I'm not going to leave you out options. My name is Faustulus Muntrot, by the way.
He bows with a smirk and he just says, "Asmodeus."
Do I recognize? Was he one of the nine?
Make a religion check.
Super good at those. Five.
Five. Looks like a yep. Dude.
It's just a big dude with big black eyes and horns. Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, but do I see the pillar behind me? Like, is it completely gone?
It's in between. He is in between you and the pillar.
Oh.
It's still there.
Okay.
And he just says, "Something is not right here. You were not sent here upon your death. You are not judged yet."
Well, I've been judged all my life. But I don't suppose it's time for final judgment.
No, I suppose not. Not with the demons on the surface.
I believe I know something about that.
Yes. We warned her. She
what
is rash.
Her?
Oh, the spider. The
you
demons.
The big old scary wolf.
She does not listen to our side. You might come in handy.
Oh, shit.
Please, I do not wish to keep you. If you wish to leave, by all means. The fire will not hurt you.
Handy in which way?
We'll just have to see.
Well, I'd like to know what I might be getting myself into.
Well, if everything goes planned, you'll be sending the so-called Lords of Hell back where they belong. I think that's handy enough. We don't want to disrupt the balance.
Surely that wouldn't be all you're asking of me, to just do the job I'm already doing.
I think that's a fairly large task.
I believe rightly so for such a small feller.
Well, you should be back at it.
May I pass through the fires?
By all means, they will not hurt you.
Can I insight check them?
Sure.
15.
You get nothing off this guy.
Try to step into the fire, like maybe reach like my hand in first.
Okay. As you reach in, he starts to laugh a little bit under his breath. It doesn't hurt you.
Okay, I'm gonna start walking towards the pillar.
As you pass by him, he puts a hand on his shoulder and just says, "Trust me, if I wanted it to hurt, it would hurt."
It's what my father used to tell me.
He leans down and goes, "I'll make sure to tell him that."
Please, please do. try to make my way to the pillar.
Okay, so you get to the pillar. What are you doing?
I guess I gotta check out this children's game.
Okay.
This maze? Is it like a cereal box maze?
Yeah, kind of. As you're about to put your hand on it, he goes, and I will be seeing you soon, Fossilis Muttontrop. As you press your hand to it, and you appear back in the maze with everybody else.
You will not believe where I just went.
What was it like?
It was a glass fortress, just covered in memorabilia of adventures past. It was amazing. In there, I saw the face of me father, and I gutted him like a fish. It was glorious, and I really don't recommend you touch the flame. It's a hot place. There's fire everywhere.
Fossilis, you look like you've been through hell and back.
Oh, well, I made a deal. I feel like I made a deal with the devil to get back here, but I had to make sure you guys were safe. I know now that it is my destiny bestowed upon me by the glorious leader. He told me so when I slew me father. Didn't tell me which way to go, though.
Can you go back and ask?
I don't think I'll be going back there anytime soon. You're more than welcome to try.
I'm good, thank you. There's one pillar left?
No, there's only ever one pillar.
Oh, it just had different symbols up.
Yeah. Okay. You guys can also tell that Fossilis reeks of sulfur.
You stink.
Well, we've been in a cave for a couple of weeks. I haven't really had time for a bath. The last bath I had was with... Now I start crying.
No, this is different from your usual musk.
You know what? Just for that, I'll play a little song to honor your last time you were in a bath with somebody. This is apparently on roll 20, so of course I got it.
So good. This should just be our battle music, too. It's beautiful.
Alright, that's enough of that.
But Tram, I can only cast spells when I'm so erect.
So I gotta look back at your guys' intelligence checks here. Kim Jong-un does not learn it. And Dawnbreaker does.
Beautiful.
Okay. So what do you guys want to do?
So this is a dead end where this pillar was?
Yeah, this is one of the dead end ways. We can just go back, I guess. I think we
we could check the other way.
Alright. I'm in agreement with this.
Yeah, I don't trust that pillar.
I don't want to hit the flame again.
Did say he's gonna see you again really soon, so.
Can I hit the flame again?
I wasn't there.
I wanna ask him if my daddy's still alive.
I don't think he is.
Was I muted when I asked for a check?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. You can press the flame. Are you going to do that?
Yes.
Okay. While he does that, can I get Kim Jong-un, Shishun, and I will roll a perception check.
perception.
8.
Okay. So you hit the flame, you disappear. As he's going into the flame, Shishun, you notice there's a symbol on the back of Faustus's neck. It was not there before.
What does it look like?
I will tell you what it looks like. It is Where's this book? It is okay. It is a triangle, a red triangle with three smaller black triangles in the center.
Do I recognize it from anything?
Is it an inverse triforce?
Kind of. Make a religion check. And are you sharing this information?
I will once I know if I can recognize it or not.
Okay.
12.
12? You do not.
Yeah, I relay it to everybody else. There's a symbol on his neck. I don't know what it means.
What did it look like?
It was a triangle with three smaller triangles inside of it. Upside down triangles.
Was it a triforce?
Jokes already been made.
Triforce of power.
He seems to be marked by something. It can't be good.
Would I be able to try a religion check for... to see if I know which...
Sure.
If it's from, like, a religion?
Dawnbreaker will also try. Nope, no, the one.
19.
That is a religious symbol. That is
Hey guys, it's a religious symbol.
That is okay. The symbol of the Lord of Nessus.
Damn dirty cultists.
I relay this information.
And their leader, Asmodeus. Sorry, not leader. The god they worship, Asmodeus.
Do you know any more of this Asmodeus, Kim Jong-un?
Do a history check.
Would I be able to history check?
Well, actually, make a religion. With advantage, because you already figured it out.
Okay. 10.
Not much other than Asmodeus is king of the nine hells. King of the devils. Supreme.
Basically...
Supreme. He's the supreme master of the nine hells.
Okay. I just relay that information to you guys.
Like a mighty...
Sorry, continue.
That's all I was going to say. He sounds like a mighty foe.
Faustus, you go back down, and the room is still on fire, and you go back down, and you don't see anybody.
Can I yell out for Asmodeus?
Sure. You don't get a response.
Okay, can I yell it out in Abyssal?
Sure. You do not get a response.
I'm gonna gingerly try to put my hand through the fire again before running.
Doesn't burn you.
Okay, I'm gonna run up and hit the maze puzzle.
Okay.
And I'm gonna try to get all the sulfur smell on me that I can.
Well, just it's on you.
Really huff it in. And hit the maze. Go back to the group. or hit the moon and log out forever. No, I'll go back to the group.
Okay. So, you guys all watch as Faustus reappears. What do you guys want to do?
So, did you find any information on your father?
Unfortunately, it appears I couldn't get the answers I desired, so maybe in the future I could try again. But I'm kind of glad, to be honest. I don't think I really wanted to know. He is dead to me, but...
By the way, Shishun noticed that you had a strange mark on the back of your neck when you were leaving there.
Oh, that's nothing. That's a tattoo I got back in Ranger School.
It's probably a
hickey. Can I make an insight check?
Sure.
That's 20.
I mean, you guys just had a conversation about this. You know he's lying.
Yeah, it's...
You know for a fact he's lying, because you guys just figured it out.
I don't know. These other motherfuckers don't seem very observant to me.
Well, there was just a conversation about it.
No.
Brightwood also hasn't been here long enough to know if it was there before or not, maybe.
It's true.
He's lying.
Well... All right.
I'll keep this information to myself.
Okay.
When I touched the flame pillar, I was transported to a dark room full of fire and flames. And I was greeted by a man in red skin with a... He was quite a horny fellow with big black eyes. Sorry. And he said his name is Asmodeus. And he was wishing us luck in our quest. And that's it.
He's marked you, you know.
Did he
you
touch
have...
you?
You have his mark on the back of your neck.
A lot of people touch me. And everyone leaves their mark on me. Some are just more visible than others. They're not scars, me friends. They're marks of a life's journey.
I'm gonna walk over, and I guess it's on the back of his neck. Hey, I can't like fucking turn his head to see it.
No.
Mirrors?
I'm really tiny. You definitely could.
Do we have any mirrors?
I don't think
probably.
You.
Yeah, probably
do?
Not.
You might. All right, never mind. I don't know. You do not have a mirror.
How shiny is our swords?
That is a great question.
Shiny enough? You want to try to get him to look at it?
Yeah, one mirror in the back, and then one in front of him to look through.
Okay.
So we can see.
Yeah, you guys could make it work.
It's like a full length for a man of Faustus' stature.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there's some tricky kind of maneuvering of the swords, but you do see a mark on the back of your neck, Faustus.
Oh, that's not the tattoo I had. This is a little bit beguiling.
The tattoo of the bear in a muscle shirt is not there anymore.
God damn! How'd you know? That was the only thing me mother ever gave me.
Holy shit.
Well, it doesn't itch, so I suppose at least the instrumentation was clean. I don't really know what this, might entail for me, but maybe we should keep an eye on it.
So what do you guys want to do?
Maybe we should go check out the other path.
Which path are you guys going to?
Check out the statue.
Or no, go ahead.
Oh, I was gonna say, do we check out both sides of the hallway? Like both hallways?
Did
no,
not.
We've only gone down one so far.
Oh, and one. Oh, sorry, my bad.
Yeah. Although I do believe I found where I want to die.
Was that that fiery place?
No. It was, it was a beautiful place. I didn't see any goats, but it was an island. A private island. With all of my favorite things in the world. Truly paradise. I'm gonna take off the necklace of adaption. And here you go, Mr. Tree Trunks. That was nice, thank you.
Oh, that's I not forgot even about mine. That. Thank you.
No, Mr. Baratheon, I apologize. The guy with the large tree trunk, I told you yesterday.
That's me.
You really gotta get your naming structure straight here.
I can't seem to remember your name. It's a really difficult one. They keep telling me, but in one ear and out the other, I suppose.
You've known me for years now.
Has it really been that long?
Sure feels like it.
Well, I don't have any negative memories, so I suppose that is a... You're not a parasite, are you? Sorry, I'm not gonna cheat. you guys wanna check out... We'll check out this other path, guys.
Yeah.
Let's check it out.
Could take a look now.
Okay. So you go down this other path. There's a pillar with a sword sitting on it. Little pedestal.
Can I check the pedestal for traps?
Sure, make an investigation check.
Investigation 15.
This thing is trapped. There is some sort of pressure plate below the sword.
Oh, so it's like a sword laid on its flat. It's not like a sword in the stone type deal.
Yes.
Okay. It appears there might be a trap on the on this really shiny, sharp-looking sword.
One of us should press it anyway to see what it does.
I'll go grab it. None of you are opposed.
I don't suppose we have any other swords to try and replace it with. Too little bit of a switcheroo.
I know. Can I use Mage Hand to go pick up the sword?
Sure.
Oh, that's using your noodle.
So your Mage Hand goes over. You're picking it up.
Nobody's near it, right?
How far away are you guys standing?
I'm gonna take like 20 feet back, seeing this magical hand.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna...
You can stand up to 30 feet away from it.
I wouldn't move, I'd stay right beside him.
Right beside the pillar, or right beside, Brightwood?
Right beside, Brightwood.
Okay. And how far are you standing away, Brightwood?
I'd probably be about 20 feet.
So your mage hand goes over, picks up the sword. Nothing seems to happen. Bring it back. Then you feel a rumbling. From behind the edge of the cave. And, let's just switch the music to give you an indication of what's about to happen.
Oh no, it's the dying music!
As the wall opens up, and a large boulder comes rolling out at you guys. What do you want to do?
How large is this boulder?
It's like big. It's fucking big.
Is it?
It's coming at you. It's coming at you.
I cast disintegrate on the boulder.
Okay. Roll damage.
How big is the boulder? Is it taking up the whole cave?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna run.
I want to grab the sword from the mage head, and I cast fly on both Ostulus and Tree.
No, I have my ebony fly figurine. Do not cast fly on me.
I was gonna say Treeky.
Okay, who's? Damage. Okay.
Sorry, I gotta turn this down. This kicked in loud.
Sorry, it came in loud. I'm turning it down.
And I want to fly from the fly away from the boulder.
Okay. Whoever's running, make a dexterity saving throw.
Would you consider them?
I already said I was running, so I'm gonna do that.
I would consider it pretty large. What are you doing, Tanner?
Seven.
Because it disintegrates larger, smaller, non-magical objects.
Okay. It's still rolling
at
you.
Wait. If the target is huge or larger, the spell disintegrates a 10-foot cube portion of it.
Well, there's a 10-foot cube portion out of it.
Is it still rolling?
Yes.
Oh, no. Oh, wait, he has advantage.
There's a 10-foot flat side on it.
Yeah. Hey, Tanner, make a dexterity saving throw, please.
Seventeen. Am I next to Tram?
Mike, did you run?
No.
Then yes, you are.
You didn't run 21. From a giant boulder.
Kim Jong Un, make a dexterity saving throw.
Okay. 8.
Okay.
Did you cast something on me, Jed?
Fly.
Yeah, I cast fly.
Okay.
And everybody else ran, correct?
Yep.
Yeah. For this turn.
Well, there's only one turn for this. Okay. Forgive me for a second, roll 8 billion dice. Actually,
we should have just fucking blew this thing up, guys. Shit.
Let me just roll the dice on here. It'll be easier. Take 70 points of bludgeoning damage as you're run over by this boulder. Kim Jong-un.
That's a pretty high fucking roll, Krex.
That is a pretty high roll. But there's some ones in there.
Yeah. Are Sir Crawl, the bear, and the rest of us safe?
Yeah, if you guys ran right off the bat.
Okay.
Okay.
All I say is, fuck you, boulder.
Everybody else makes it to the end. The boulder rolls, you guys kind of duck in one of the other ways off, and a boulder continues back the way you guys came, and just keeps rolling out.
It's almost as if I saw that one coming. Oh, I should quit my day job and become a psychic. Oh.
What are the chances that 10-foot cube caught Tram as it rolled over?
Nope.
Probably landed on the flat side looking at that.
There's gotta be consequences to not running from a boulder.
Nah, oh, it's gonna just fucking take it, man.
If you didn't decide to run right away, you're pretty much getting run over.
I was
going
to try and swing at it like a bat, but then you said it was the size of the cave, so I decided to run.
Brightwood, you have a longsword.
Cool.
It's got a little rust on it, but you do have a longsword.
No possible consequences to hanging onto this sword.
Well, we just risked our lives for it, so you better hold on to it. Make the trip worth it.
That's what I'm doing. God.
All right. What are you guys doing now?
Okay.
We only got one path.
El Greco, is it a magical sword? Can you tell?
I guess I'll roll Arcana on it.
Sure.
Oh, yeah. Wait. Yeah, that's just a check, right?
I'm gonna just fucking light up like a goddamn candle.
No, I was thinking detect magic, but
that's a sword.
No. I'm still concentrating to find the path. We'll get lost in here if I drop this. I'm talking like fossilist. Damn you, Greg. Brain fucked me.
Well, I believe that's a little bit of cultural appropriation, me son. That's a thing for white people, not for Mexicans.
Alright, what do you guys want to do?
Let's go down the last path, I guess.
Away the Minotaurs?
Yep.
That it tells you to go? Or the other one?
But I know
there's the way.
There's a fourth path, yes.
Oh, I thought
that
it was
be
just
the way we came?
Nope. Nope.
With the way we came, left, right, forward.
There was four different ways.
Yep.
Two of them we could see the end, and two we could not. You just went down one of them.
Hmm.
Well,
that way's the right way, and I don't know what's down there, but...
Is the weird pyramid guy just following along?
Yeah, he's trying to recalculate his position.
Is he trying to triangulate his location?
I hate you!
You're now level 11.
13, if anything. I don't know. About...
Son of a bitch. Yeah, there are two more paths. Find the path goes down one. The other one goes off somewhere.
Let's go off somewhere.
YOLO!
And we marked the path right, which is the right path?
We did, Tanner marked the right one.
Okay.
Well, you know where it is.
Well, just in case.
Okay.
Yeah. Would I know if this sword is magical or not?
Make an arcana check.
Feel of it. 16.
It doesn't appear to be magical.
Haha, you're dumb.
Am I?
Got a minus one.
So?
You're dumb.
I am not an arch.
So you guys want to go down the other path?
Yeah, let's go down the other, not the path.
Okay.
Fuck it.
So you guys start what? How, are you looking for anything in specific? Or you just want to follow the tunnel?
We're just checking it out.
Okay. So after about an hour, you're still following the tunnel. It's just winding around. There does not appear to be an end to it yet. Do you want to keep going down there?
Well, my feet are getting a little tired. Do you guys want to try to turn around, or
has the scenery changed at all, or does it just look like
everything? Every cave and every tunnel in here looks almost identical. Almost like it's a maze.
Input, anyone?
I say we keep going. It'd be wimpy to turn back now.
We're already committed an hour in. We may as well see this to the end.
Yeah.
Alright, that's exactly what I say when I sit down and watch an episode of Netflix. Turns into a season.
Okay, so you guys walk probably for like two more hours. And then the cavern starts opening up ahead. And then it looks like you see in this, it opens up into like a large opening. And it looks to be some sort of settlement with tents and crudely built shanties lining its irregular walls. It appears to be deserted except for a lone human male kneeling within a circle of burned torch stalk mushrooms in the center of a cave with two ragged figures lurking near a zirkwood door set into a wall 30 feet distant. The figure in the circle is praying over a rotting minotaur, head, but stands when he sees you. He's a thin human. His face and arms are streaked with dry blood. He says, friends, I have heard the call, and I hope you have too. With my own eyes, I saw our great lord Yonogu slaughter the minotaurs that have plagued us. Now we are free and strong with his blessings. We feast while we live, and thanks to our lord, we will also feast when we are dead. I've heard the call. Come, join my pack and feel the strength of Yonogu. The figure smiles as he speaks, revealing teeth filed to sharp points.
The hell is Yonogu?
Have any of you guys heard of Yonogu? Kind of looking over towards the paladins.
Yeah, I know.
Could I try a religion check to see if I recall his name?
Sure, with advantage, because you've heard the name before.
16.
What is your intelligence modifier?
2.
2.
Plus 2.
You have heard the name before, because that is one of the visions you had in the library. Of the demon lord Yonogu.
Ooh.
The beast of butchery.
Well, guys, Yonogu's one of the demon lords that we had a vision of in the library. This guy is batshit insane.
How many humanoids are there?
Three.
One. Oh, wait. Three? What?
Three.
Okay.
There's the one human and then his two ragged followers.
I'll just look at Kim Jong-un, say, you mean these are followers of the demon lords?
Yes.
I'll summon my pack weapon into my hand.
Okay.
I'll approach them.
As you approach, he goes, yes, you want to see the greatness that is Lord Yonogu and feast with us. Please come enjoy us. We have slain the minotaur for Yonogu, and he gives us the body to feast upon.
I cast Leon hands on Tram.
Okay. I tell him I have no intention of doing any such thing.
I also cast Leon hands on myself.
Okay.
And
he goes, why would you defile the name of Yonogu? He only wishes to bless us with life and afterlife.
Can I cast Hunter's Mark on this guy?
Without him knowing?
Ooh. Do they know if they've been Hunter's Marked?
You're pretty proficient with Hunter's Mark. They could know. You can make a sleight of hand check.
Would like to cast Hold Person on all of them. Are they within 30 feet of each other?
They are.
It's a 10.
Yeah, I'd like to cast Hold Person on all of them.
Yeah, he doesn't notice. Okay, what's your spell save DC?
17.
Okay, let me find his stats.
Wisdom save.
He's got some weird specific stats I need to find here real quick. Wisdom save, yes?
Yep.
And you said 17. Grisha succeeds. Fail on one of the humanoids, fail on the second humanoid. And they are paralyzed, correct?
Yep.
Grisha goes, he goes, why would you do this? You wish to anger Yonogu. How dare you?
I tell him it's a good thing. You know who's gonna beat him in the afterlife.
He goes, why would you come to our village and say such angry things. I will ask you, please, release my followers.
Fuck, what should I do?
I don't know, it's up to you.
Do what you believe you feel is right in your heart, and we'll judge you for your actions. Harshly and immediately.
We can't let Yanogu gain influence in this world.
I'd like to walk over to the followers that are... or one of the followers that are held still.
Okay.
And
they are
attack him.
Okay.
With my weapon.
I'll let that go off, and then everybody roll initiative, please. Once I pull up the initiative thing.
Nick, I was just wondering, how much did you heal me for with my hand?
Oh, 25.
Okay.
All right. Everybody can roll initiative.
Okay. Can we take a quick break and grab some food?
Yeah, I gotta queue up some of that domino.
Yeah, I gotta piss like a motherfucker.
Ooh, oh, natural 20.
Nice, Tanner. Ha ha! You got wheaten, bro. Anyways, yeah, I'll be right back.
There's my character.
I'm gonna re-roll for initiative because I have advantage on that I didn't use.
Okay.
Also because it was a natural one, so it can't be worse. 16!
It's pretty good. Just roll Grisha. Oh. Alright, and
did
we can
you
take...
figure out the spell you're taking?
Yeah, I picked True Sight.
Oh, okay, cool.
It was between that and Conjure Fae. I was thinking about just summoning unicorns.
Pink fluffy unicorns.
Yeah, unicorns are strong, and they can teleport and cast pass without a trace.
And they're
healing
fluffy.
Touch.
And they're fluffy.
Right?
I don't think they're fluffy.
Is everybody familiar with the song?
No, I just know unicorns are fluffy.
Oh, okay.
Just what for song, you, Grant? It's not really dancing on the rainbow.
Tents and shanties. Yep. Is everybody back?
I think we're waiting on Nick.
I'm back.
Okay. And Tanner's here?
Yep.
And Mike's here?
Yep.
Okay, so I'm just gonna move.
Joseph?
Yes.
Let me put
I sounded slightly unsure about that.
Am I here? Do I want another 5 minutes to myself to masturbate?
5 minutes? I'll need another 30 seconds.
I'm gonna put out some shitty tokens real quick.
Dude, 2 minutes. Everyone knows it takes 4.5 minutes to find a good video. Come on.
But I already found pink fluffy unicorns. That is the best video.
Oh god. You fucking weirdo.
You guys are definitely next to each other. You guys are just down in here, in this kind of area here. And Roland is next to the big door and that dude. So Roland,
Is dead. He's around my neck.
You can, what's your max damage?
I guess it's 15 on the hit.
All right. I guess you have to roll a hit. But what's your max damage? It's a crit.
On the dice, 8 plus 7.
That's the highest you can roll is 15.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me just see here. He's dead. And then it goes into initiative. Fossilis, you're up.
Okay. How far is that other guy from me? 50 feet. I'm a bonus action dash up to the other guy.
Okay.
That's held. And, can sword him.
Okay.
Do I have to roll to hit?
Yep. You have advantage. What's max damage?
22. So I get my sneak attack if it's an advantage attack, right?
Yep.
So that is 6 plus 6 plus 7, 19.
Yeah, he's dead. Okay. Tricky. You guys are killing people.
I'm going to... I'm going to try to hold monster him.
Okay.
Wisdom save. DC, I think, is 17. Yeah. No, 16.
Fails. Okay. He is paralyzed. Okay. It's Follow's turn. You guys killed two. The other 10 will come out now. Okay.
And who's that blonde one in the middle?
That's the, like...
Grisha.
Guy with spiky teeth. Yeah, Grisha. Mm.
Okay. Make some attacks here. Against Bear... We will... Yep, we'll just roll with our scimitar. That is a 19 to hit. On the bear.
That hits.
For 2 damage.
Oh, okay.
Treaky. That's a 16.
As my reaction, I'll cast shield, and okay. It doesn't hit.
Okay. Again, Shashun, there'll be two. First one is a 12.
Nope.
Second one's a 13.
Nope.
Okay, against El Greco Vegro, that's a natural one.
Nope.
One against Fostilus.
Okay.
17.
Nope, AC 18.
Ooh. Three against Brightwood. Well, nope. Natural 20. And a one. So, seven.
I take seven damage?
Seven. That's the max he can do to you. El Greco Vegro, you guys are killing civilians again.
Again? God damn it.
Well.
Follow the Demon Lord, man.
They did express that they were following Yanogu.
Ah, well, now it's all cool then.
They're not civilians, they're evil. They're less than people.
Yeah.
They're Peruvian.
They are cultists.
Peruvian. Alright, well, I'm
sorry, they're what, Krugs?
What's that?
You said they are
cultists.
Okay.
So, I'm gonna go on Giant Scorpion.
Okay.
Gonna take my claw attacks against the one that's closest to me there.
Okay.
Watch this stinger be a fucking nat 20 and just explode somebody's face.
Hit.
And
hit.
And that is 1d8 plus 2.
Yeah, he's dead.
He's dead? Okay.
Yep.
Then I'll move up to fuckballs.
Okay. You have advantage on the strike.
And that's for my sting.
Which is an auto crit.
Oh, he's paralyzed? Oh, okay. Well, that's awesome.
Well, you gotta still hit him first.
Oh, okay. Nah.
You have advantage.
Nah.
You still managed to miss him.
Take sting either. Both attempts right beside each other.
Anticipating his movement, you. you strike thin air.
Sir Crawl. Joseph?
Barney Rubble!
I'm still here, man. Don't worry, my dog just threw up, so I have to clean that up in a minute.
Okay.
Is anybody still paralyzed?
Grisha, the main one is, yes.
And I get an automatic critical.
If you hit him.
That one I've just pinged.
Okay. I am going to run up to... Yeah, I want to go between those two people, I guess. So I'm going to run to here.
Okay.
I'm going to attack Grisha. And okay. So it's an automatic critical as long as I hit?
Yes.
And you have okay. Advantage to hit.
Then I am going to attack her, and I'm going to do the minus 5 and plus 5 to the attack.
Okay.
Yeah. So now let me open that guy up. And now if I do hit on her, I automatically get another bonus attack because of Great Weapon Master, which is pretty cool balls.
Correct.
With your bonus action?
Yeah. Although I don't think I'll be able to take advantage of it because I still have another attack I could do anyways.
You still can.
Yeah, I mean, if you kill
I guess
her
I'm
with that hit,
I kill both
you
of them,
kill
I might
the
not,
dude
so.
Below you as well and probably another dude with the bonus action.
Alright, so roll your attacks with advantage with minus okay. 5 to the number. Miss?
That was a miss? Really?
You have advantage?
Okay.
Yeah, minus 5 to that. So well, that's a 14.
Doing the advantage toggle there. So he's counting the left and right.
Oh, yeah. Roll it twice. Don't do that toggle.
Oh, you don't do that toggle?
Yeah.
Okay. So 19 was a miss, though?
Yes. Well, okay. It's minus 5. That's 14. But roll again with it for your advantage.
Okay, gotcha.
Nope.
That was a natural one on that one. So I'm going to try and hit them again, this time without using that advantage thing.
Okay. Was that great weapon master?
I'm using the minus 5 thing.
That's a miss. So
15, does that hit? 23.
That hits.
Okay, cool.
So what's maximum damage on your tree?
Maximum damage on my tree is 19?
Not including rage bonus because you're not raging?
Yeah, because I forgot to rage. Still 19.
Okay.
And I will enrage at this point and then hit for my second
That was your attack. Second.
No, I get two attacks, and because I hit a critical, I get an extra
attack. And you raged with your bonus action already.
Wrecked.
Oh, that's a bonus action to aid.
Yes.
Okay, well, that's the important thing. I should have raged. Okay, cool. Okay.
However, you really did fuck him up. Super hard.
Good. That's what I wanted to do.
Shashoon.
Tree trunk.
So I probably wouldn't want to hurt the normal cultists. I'm going to go and just run straight for the leader.
Okay.
I'll probably take some opportunity attacks.
You will take 3.
Yep.
15.
Miss.
16.
Hit.
And 16.
Hit.
So, fuck. 5.
Total? For both?
Yep.
Damn.
They're not good.
I brush off my shoulder.
You're killing some fucking weak-ass cultist.
I'll swing twice at the leader when I get to him.
Okay.
First roll's 26.
Hits.
Second's 18.
It misses.
Damn, okay. Alright, I'm gonna smite him with a second level spell slot.
Okay, so what's max damage on that?
D6 plus 6. So 12 plus 3d8. So 24. So 36.
Yeah, he's dead.
Oh no.
Boop. Okay.
When he dies, do the cultists come out of a stupor at all, or are they still aggressive?
They do not appear to. Bear. At least you don't know if they do yet.
Okay. The bear got hit. So he's gonna multi-attack the guy next to him.
Okay.
Self-defense, yo.
Hit.
No, it was a 9 and a natural 1.
Oh.
Double-click the second bite.
So miss and miss.
Yep.
Kim Jong-un.
Alright. I'm gonna go right up here.
Okay.
And I'm gonna hit both the guys. Well, one guy right underneath of tree trunks.
Okay.
For my bonus action, I'm also gonna activate my sword. Flame.
Okay.
Sword.
Flame tongue long sword.
Hits.
28. 24.
Yep, he's dead.
And I'm also gonna have my bonus attack on the other guy then.
Okay.
Shoot, just closed.
It. 29. Hits.
And 28 damage.
Dead.
Okay, that's my turn.
Brightwood.
I'd like to make melee attacks against the two right beside me.
Okay.
24 to hit.
Hits.
And 22 to hit.
Hits.
Oh. Dealing 8 and 15 damage.
The one right beside you is dead. The other one is barely alive.
Okay.
Grisha doesn't get a turn because you guys murdered her. Him. Stupid name for a dude. Fossless. Are you muted?
Yes, I am. I'm gonna go the non-aggressive route, and okay. kind of put on my shield and say, if you put down your arms, there's no need for the rest of you to be murdered today. We can take you all out with the sneeze. Put down your arms and walk away.
Make a charisma check.
Or persuasion. Really good charisma. 7.
Okay.
That's why we kill people. Can't win any rolls.
I tried once, now I can go back to murdering for the rest of the campaign.
That was Yogi's.
Treaky.
It's the exact same. We have the same charisma score. It's because I clicked on my page with the as name. It doesn't change automatically.
You're as charismatic as a bear, Greg.
No, the bear's actually got minus 2. That's wrong.
I guess I'll just firebolt this one next to me.
Okay. Attack with disadvantage.
The 15.
That hits.
I think that's 3d8 now.
It is.
Twelve.
He did. Okay, so...
And as a bonus action, I want to tap the Wand of Secrets.
Okay. I don't think you see anything. I will double check that for you in a sec. One of the ones beside you, Fossilis right here, says, I don't think we need to die today. Do you mind if I just leave?
Please, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, he walks up to the door and he opens up the big doors and he runs inside. He's off the map.
Big doors behind us?
Great, Fossilis. You let him go tell everyone else we're here.
The other one beside you is still going to attack you.
May I make an attack of opportunity against the guy running away?
Yes, you may.
Sorry, Greg.
Trying to be the good guy over here.
Yep. He's dead. He runs in and you slash his back and he just falls over.
I look at Lord Brightwood slightly aghast.
One's gonna attack you, Brightwood.
14. He didn't promise to change his ways.
14 hits? No?
No.
One on Fossilis? Nope, that's a 9. One on Bear? 18.
That hits.
For 5.
Okay.
This one's gonna run over to Treaky. Attack him. 16.
Miss.
Okay. Yeah, that's the end of their turn. El Greco Vegro.
Oh, wait, all no, right. Sorry.
That's a hit.
That would hit me.
Or 2.
Okay.
I'm gonna move up to the bear
Okay. As he sees a giant scorpion and a bear in front of him now, you just hear him go, oh!
And claw.
Hit.
Claw.
Hit.
Damage, damage.
Dead, dead.
And I should have enough movement to move to the other guy?
Yep.
15? Yeah. Okay. And I move up to him, and I will tail attack.
Okay.
Oh.
That hits?
Oh, okay.
Their challenge rating, like, 1/8.
Oh. Damn civilians.
Sorry, they're actually challenge rating 1.
12 but... damage.
He did.
And Stinger burst through his chest, sprained
from him. If you ever seen a person explode, now is when you do it. Sir Crawl.
Okay, who's still alive?
I just got back from killing two crap.
It's two at the top.
Okay,
I guess we're probably not gonna get alive for questioning.
I'm going to run. How can I see how far away something is?
There's a little ruler on the top left there, and if you click it.
Or every square is 5 feet. As well.
Yeah, it's yeah. Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
You're on the pointer or the pen, sorry.
Yeah.
There's a little ruler too down.
And I can select that. Yeah.
Here we go.
Yeah, you can just drag select it with the pointer and press delete.
So it's 25 to go there. So okay. Cool. And it's just those two guys here that's alive.
Yeah.
So I'm going to run to here.
You gotta reselect your cursor.
25 feet to here.
There you go.
While still enraged, I'm going to attack this guy here.
Okay.
And give me a second to pull my sheet up. I can do a fucking roll. Blah, blah, blah. I'm not gonna do the minus thing because I don't think I have advantage on him and I don't care at this point. Actually, yeah, I'm going to
cleave his fucking skull off.
I'm gonna do the thing that gives me advantage, but anybody that attacks me next turn gets or has advantage against me.
Reckless attack. Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna recklessly attack this motherfucker right here.
Okay.
Fucking base.
And let's do this, Tree Trunks. We got this one. What's the first roll?
That is a 17. That hits.
Okay, I just want to make sure it's not gonna be a critical, because there's a chance it's a critical. It's a critical!
How much damage do you do? Just curious.
You get to roll so many dice.
So it's it's 19 base plus 10 is 29 plus 3. Are you plus 3 on your rage?
I'm plus 3 on my rage, yeah. So and I have 1d12.
So 32. I don't think he gets brutal critical, does he? He's not a frenzy barb.
Oh,
I think I still get brutal critical.
Okay. So at level 12, you get two additional d12s.
It's just at one?
Which you just get to roll normally.
Yeah, I can roll one additional weapon damage die when determining the extra damage for critical hit to the melee attack. And yeah.
I'm not it's level 13 he gets the second
critical. So you get to roll an additional d12, I believe.
Yeah.
So roll d12 on top of your 32 damage.
What was his weapon damage? 1d8?
12.
1d12? So he gets an additional...
d12.
Oh, that's what he was also talking about?
Yes.
Yeah.
How do I just roll a d12?
There's a dice roller on the left side.
Under the ruler.
Oh, gotcha. Oh, 1d not 20. I'm not that awesome. Yeah. And I don't have rage on the second, it's just a straight up d12, right?
It's just a straight d12. So you do 35 damage to his total of 9 hit points.
Nice.
And
now that I'm critical, I get an additional turn after the attack on this guy, though.
Yes, you do.
So I'm going to move to him, and I'm going to attack again with advantage.
Okay. Roll twice.
I really need to get my mouse out. It's bullshit. Okay.
Okay, that hits.
Excellent.
I'm just gonna say he's dead. Because yeah, your plus 10 auto kills him. So I guess that's your turn, hey?
No, I still have one final bonus action, so I scream into the air! Okay.
You should have attacked our teammate.
At the end of your turn,
Ma!
You hear a moaning sound.
Ooh.
From inside the door as six ghouls come walking out.
And one is sucking your dick, dude.
They're all gonna be sucking my dick.
Oh man, I just saw that. That was fucking awesome.
Battle BJs.
Alright. Two on Roland. That's a... Roland.
Who's that?
So he's attacking the thing around Fossilis's neck.
Those things not Roland. Power Rangers. Brightwood.
Yeah, right, Grant?
First attack is a 17.
Miss.
That's a miss. Second attack is a... Nope, that's also a miss. One on Fossilis.
Okay.
That's a 19.
That's a miss. My AC is 20. I forgot I had the shield up. I said it last round. I forgot it was a 2.
Okay. Three on our lovely Sir Kral with advantage. First one's a 22, but we'll see if we crit. We don't. Second one is an 11, or nope, that's a miss. Third one is a 23, so two hits.
Why are you picking on me?
Because I have advantage on you. So you take 3 slashing damage and 11 slashing damage for a total of 14 reduced to 7. And I need you to make 2 constitution saving throws.
Oh, do I get a bonus to constitution saving throws?
You do, you're a barbarian.
Well, you get your normal constitution, you'll get an additional bonus to it.
Oh, yeah, you're proficient in it.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure it wasn't, because I know I get advantage. Oh, I get advantage in strength saves, okay. Cool. So I'm going to take my 7 damage. And then I'm going to, I need to do 2 constitution.
Yep. Please.
Okay. Just a second. It's first one. It's not a good one.
Don't bother rolling the second one. You are paralyzed. Shishun.
Okay.
I'm going to move up and I'm going to smite 2 of them basically.
You get the additional damage on your smite.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking. All right, I'll roll to hit the one that's right in front of me first.
Okay.
25.
Hits.
Okay, 1 sec. Fifteen damage.
It is still alive.
Okay, I'll hit it with my second attack then.
Okay.
That's probably gonna miss. 12.
Hits.
Ooh, ghouls. Okay. Ten damage.
He is dead.
Nice. That's my turn.
Alright, that would be... I don't know why I went... My thing reset. Bear. Yeah, it's Bear's turn.
I'm gonna pull him over here. So you're gonna have a bear kind of shove past you a little bit. It's gonna come up there. And he's going to multi-attack the one on the left.
Okay.
Sixteen.
Hit. 10 is a miss.
10? Okay. Are these fiends?
No.
Okay. 10 damage.
Okay. Alright, Brightwood.
I will attack the one between me and Faustulus.
Okay.
Fourteen to hit.
Yep.
9 damage.
Okay. Still up.
21 to hit. 8 damage.
Okay. Still up.
Okay.
Kim Jong-un.
Alright. I'm going up there. So I'm gonna attack the one that's right in front of me.
Okay. Have you been adding your passive smite that's always on?
Yes. It's in my damage there.
14
hits.
To hit. You'll roll an additional d8 because it is undead.
Okay, I'll just roll an additional d8 here. So it is 10 to 4, so 16.
That's like the lowest you could possibly roll on everything. Whatever that for. And that's still pretty good damage. Okay, it is still up.
I still have my second attack, so I'm gonna swing away.
It's dead. Right. It's dead. Okay. I'm not even gonna bother. It's dead. Fossilis.
Okay. I'm gonna use my bonus action to move the Hunter's Mark from dead dude Grisha or whatever.
Okay.
To the one between the bear and I.
Okay.
I'm gonna take a short sword attack.
Okay.
24 to hit.
Hits.
Okay. 15 damage.
It's dead. Anything else?
Nope.
Okay, Tricky.
Oh, wait. I can use the bear's reaction to make an attack, too.
Okay.
I'm going to do that. Just to the guy next to him. Nat 20.
Okay. That's not the one you previously hit. What's max damage on that?
That is 15.
Okay, he's still up. Okay, Tricky, go.
I'm going to twinned firebolt and hit the two in the line, like between Brightwood and Faustulus, and then the one next to the bear.
Okay, roll the second attack with disadvantage.
Okay.
It's a big Goliath in your way.
The first one's a 10.
10 misses.
And the other one's 25.
That hits. Which one was disadvantage? The 10?
The back one.
Okay.
No, the 25. I rolled a 17 and a 19 on the disadvantage, and I rolled a 2 on the...
On the front one.
One. Yeah.
Okay. So the back one's getting hit.
16.
He did. I guess there's no followers anymore, so Greco Vagro.
Alright.
Killing everything.
I'm gonna move right up to the.
Well, they're ghouls. It's not like we're killing
them. Yeah.
I'm gonna give them the clamps.
Okay.
We're not in Tenpenny Tower.
Those are both hits. Yeah, he did.
Damage. He's dead. Oh.
Sir Crawl is paralyzed, but you can make a constitution saving throw at the end of your turn.
Oh, I rolled the wrong dice for that, but it doesn't matter. He died anyway.
Yeah. You are unparalyzed at the end of your turn. The last remaining ghoul is going to attack you again.
Okay. I'm also not enraged at this point.
You took damage last round. So you're fine.
Yeah, but it's my turn again, and on my turn, I didn't attack anything.
That's true.
So there's that.
Okay, so a 18 to hit.
That hits. That totally hits.
For a total of 8 points of slashing damage, and I need you... Sorry, not 8, 7. And I need you to make a constitution half. Saving throw. No, it's not half. He's not raging.
Not half. I went a full turn because I was paralyzed. I think that is the first time I took full damage this game.
It's true.
That
constitution saving throw.
Don't change the subject. Ha!
Okay, ha! You're fine. Shashun, there is one ghoul remaining.
I'm gonna rush over and attack it.
Okay.
Uh, 22.
Yep.
Hits probably. Eleven damage.
Yeah, he did. And that is all the ghouls. So you guys are now in a town full of corpses. What do you want to do?
I inspect the shanty on the left.
Yeah, I'm going to start looking through the houses, seeing if there's anything related to their...
Okay, if everybody... People who are looking through the houses, roll investigation.
I'm going to check out Grisha's corpse.
19.
You can roll investigation 8. As well.
Investigation. 13.
I got a 22, Krugs.
Okay. In the houses, there are some rotting raw minotaur meat, and nothing else really of any value. On Grisha, you find a flail. Everything else is pretty shitty.
Is it a nice looking flail?
Pretty nice looking flail.
Does it feel magical?
Don't touch it.
Make an arcana check.
I'm touching it. That's a 9.
It's a nice flail.
I got a nice flail, you guys! I'm gonna try to swing it around.
Yeah, it's a flail, so it swings.
Sweet. I don't hit myself with it.
I'm
a flail master!
Make a dexterity check.
Oh, of course. 9.
No, you're fine.
Roll damage.
That's,
what kind of armor are they wearing?
They are wearing, I'll tell you.
Shirts.
Basically.
Raw minotaur skin.
Wax. Spun.
They're wearing very basic leather armor.
What about Grisha?
Grisha is wearing a chain. And has a shield.
That's basic leather armor.
Use any of Grisha's spells.
I hope that wasn't your favorite encounter and we ruined it for you.
It was not.
Okay, good. I would have felt really bad.
A bunch of cultists.
Don't worry, he'll just kill us in the next room if it was.
It's true.
Yeah, nothing else really of value that you guys can find.
There's no notes or nothing. No, like,
nope.
You know, cryptic scribbling in the sand or nothing like that.
Nope.
Hey, team, let's go investigate this room the ghouls came out of.
Yeah, I'd like to look at that big door.
It's a big door.
Like, there's nothing special about it.
But the door?
Yeah.
Nope, it's a big door.
I open the big door.
The door is open. That's how the ghouls came out.
I walk through the door and do a perception test with my dim vision, dim light vision.
Okay.
Natural 20.
It is an empty cave.
Oh.
Hey, guys. It would appear that they stored ghouls in here.
It would appear that they used to store ghouls in here. I wonder what happened to them.
Why did they... You didn't just store ghouls in there. Why did he try and run away into the room of ghouls?
They could have been friendly.
Didn't seem very friendly to us.
Well, it's because we just killed the leader. Of course they're not going to be friendly to us. What kind of nonsense is that?
Maybe we saved them from turmoil, and they still were ungrateful about it because they were mean ghouls.
From the back of the shantytown, you guys can hear, recalculating, 30 miles. Must continue. And your pyramid head guy starts walking away.
Oh no! I follow him.
I follow.
Yep. After him. Yep.
He leads you guys all the way back.
I'd like to throw a firebolt at the furthest back tent as we leave.
Okay. So you guys walked into a town, listened to their sermon, killed them all, burned their town down.
Sounds about right.
They were dirty cultist followers, harboring ghouls, eating the flesh of an innocent sentient being.
I don't really know how we're taking the moral low ground on this. We did the world a favor. We're heroes, if nothing else.
Just because they were half man, half beast, a little different than them, they had to kill them.
So he leads you all the way back to the four-way fork that you guys came from, and he starts to point down the path that you can sense. Which, can you maintain concentration in beast form?
Nope. Well, I don't know. I don't think so.
You can.
Can you?
Did
yeah,
you get
okay.
hit at all during that?
I did not get hit.
Okay.
Read a fucking book.
Oh, fuck you. I got you, Jed. Got you, bae. So I guess I'm still concentrating it then.
Okay. You are. And he wants you to go down that path.
Okay. So I'll follow him down that path. Game.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yep, I think we're all going.
Okay. About 40 feet from where this path starts, it turns sharply, and when you guys get about 20 feet from it, you see a knoll that creep out from the shadows right in front. And he's glancing cautiously at you guys, and he's looking side to side. It has a filthy body he's like bent and covered in tatters of clothing and scraps of blood-crusted armor. The creature then starts looking over you with his one good eye, and the other one is lost in a mass of scar tissue. And he starts to... he's basically a humanoid, like, hyena. For those who don't know what a gnoll is. And he's almost like kind of... He's not barking loud, like, he's barking like he's trying to speak to you. I'm guessing nobody speaks gnoll. And he's kind of pantomiming things now, and barking.
I raise my hand.
Yeah, I love you, Grant.
And he sees acknowledgement, and he puts up one finger, and then he starts to say something in Abyssal.
I speak Abyssal.
I believe Nick does as well.
He does.
Yep.
And he just says, Abyssal not good. We speak?
We do.
I'm
believe you're better at the demon tongue than I am.
You help me speak?
I'll relay your message.
You are powerful masters.
That's right.
You honor us by your presence. Seek you passage through the maze? The spiral of the great horned king? I can help, yes. Trust Gash and he will see you through the maze, he will.
Can I insight check Gash?
Sure.
I wish my score was better, but 12.
It's genuinely apparent you're telling the truth.
I hate you, Grant.
He seems willing to help you.
Does he speak of Asmodeus?
Who?
Your great horned demon.
Not Asmodeus.
Oh shit. Okay.
Great horned king, very dangerous. Gash, lead you away from danger.
The king of the Minotaurs.
You know.
I guessed.
Yes, I lead you away from them. Safe place.
Well, we'll discuss it amongst ourselves and then let you know. I relay everything to the group. And what do you guys want to do? You want to trust him?
I ask you to ask what's in it for him if he's leading us away. Why is he doing this for us?
That's a good question. I turn back to him and say, what's in it for you? Why do you want to help us?
You powerful. Minotaurs, very scary.
Carl, insight, see if he's lying to me.
Sure.
I'm pretty sure.
19.
This is the first night that we've ever done insights like concurrently.
I'm pretty sure this pussy just needs a.
He's not telling the whole
to
truth.
Take out an asshole. All right.
Sorry, what? He's not lying to me.
He's not telling the whole truth.
Oh, I press him further for information. I say, I don't think that sounds right. What else are you not telling us?
I show you safe way. Please, you must come with me.
I'm gonna draw my sword and point it at him.
No! Don't! Please!
Seems like pretty damn powerful.
Very powerful, masters!
And tell me what the hell it is you're hiding from us. It's all an abyssal.
I'm gonna point an arrow at him as well.
I draw my wand and point it as well.
Starting to get a little antsy at this point. I need you to I need you to make a intimidation check.
All three of us or
just Shishun.
14.
Okay. He goes, I'm very sorry. They make me say things.
Who?
The big beasts. We fight them many years ago, but they captured me because I did not want to fight. They make me lead people into their traps.
The Minotaurs?
Yes, they beat me.
I'm gonna attack him.
Okay.
And I'm gonna smite him when I do.
Okay.
Jeez. Just no bullshit, eh?
If it doesn't kill him, I'll let off an arrow.
Okay.
You fucking savages.
26.
A hit. He's already badly wounded, so this will probably just outright kill him.
Nine damage.
No, he's not dead.
Okay.
He's down trying to crawl away with one arm right now.
So he's considered prone?
Yep.
So I have disadvantage on the attack?
Yep.
Okay.
You can hear him going like, rrr,
rrr. That's 24.
That hits.
So that's... do I get sneak attack?
No, but you don't need it. You put an arrow in his head.
So is,
That one might cost you.
Is taking prisoners to gain information just not a thing we do?
Killing a chaotic good creature is not good.
What did he say that made you attack him, though?
He said that he had sent many people to their demise into the traps of the Minotaurs. He was trying to trick us.
Well,
but he was telling you this?
Traps were.
Yes, he spoke.
Yeah, he would have been able to give us some information on where these traps were, maybe.
It's a good point, but I don't trust him.
Well, we can't trust him now, he's dead.
Yep.
I got a question, Krugs. If technically, do mobs follow the same rule that we do with saving throws, so could we still res him? With
he's dead.
Heal? Okay.
He was so badly wounded. Like, he was already, like, so badly wounded that he wasn't coming back.
Okay, we're using diamonds, guys. Okay.
Yeah, he's been beaten for a couple of years, so he's very badly wounded.
Well,
anyone remember the tricks from that cave way back in Gracklestaw?
Why?
A man was able to speak with the dead. Is anyone here able to do that?
Nope.
I pick up his head and move his jaw and make crude voices in the corner of my mouth.
Anyway.
Yeah, see him? All right.
Shishun, why was he leading people into traps?
I'm not entirely sure. The gnolls are probably slaves of the Minotaurs. He was afraid of them, that's for sure.
So he was just leading people into traps to preserve his own life? He killed the man for this?
Yep. I didn't trust him. I figured he was just going to lead us into a further trap, and he was only lying to save his own skin. If he's done so for now, then what makes you think that he's all of a sudden going to save us?
Because we have the power to kill his captors.
He doesn't know that.
Yeah. He could have saw us kill the... We killed two Minotaurs already, right? I wasn't here last week.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe he saw us kill two Minotaurs already.
Maybe.
Unlikely, that was pretty far away from here. Many hours travel.
Regardless, I feel as though we should go talk to this.
To what?
Tires. See if,
You're cutting out bad, Joe.
Oh. Sorry. Is this any better?
Possibly.
I don't know. You're not saying anything right now.
That's definitely worse. You're moving. No, that's fine.
Okay. Well,
but the moving of your mic was real bad.
We should go talk to this king of the Minotaurs. See if we can get one of his subjects to this maze.
And how do you propose we convince this king?
Everyone has a price.
We're carrying a lot of gold. What if he decides to steal it from us and lock us away in the dungeon? We've already killed, two of his citizens or guards?
And what's to say he's not going to try and kill us on sight, really? I mean, the two that attacked us previously had just charged at us.
Well, if they do that, we kill some of them, and then maybe after that they would like to hear what we have to say.
I don't think killing a few of them is going to get them to stop attacking us. It hasn't worked for us yet, but... Well, it has worked once, but then you killed the guy. You stabbed him in the back, as I recall.
You mean the fleeing man?
Yeah, we convinced him that his life was worth living, and then you stabbed him in the back as he was leaving.
As he released ghouls, the follower of the Demon King, or the Demon Lord.
They could have just been swayed with pretty words.
I do have to say, I am a little bit embarrassed about trusting him. He did put us in danger. Should have just killed him.
But we can't let one person's actions dictate how we, you know, deal with every encounter we come across.
Anyways.
Just because law of averages. One.
It has to work someday. And if we go in there and we get attacked first, and we only attack them in self-defense, and we try our best not to kill anyone, knock them unconscious, something.
How do you do that? We still haven't figured this out yet.
Try knock them on the skull with your mace without crushing their whole skull.
I have a sword. It just cleaves them.
Oh. I don't know then. Cut off his legs?
Oh, I just got a bit of an idea. I'm gonna pull out, can I grab like a rock or something?
Yeah, those rocks on the ground.
From the ground. Okay, I'm gonna pull out a little tiny little, I think it's like a bluish purplish liquid in a vial, and drop a drop on it, and pass it to Mr. Tree Trunks.
Okay.
I take this rock.
Could you be tasting this rock for me? I want to know if my super juice is still powerful.
Well, fuck, what is this again?
Episode 1.
Oh my god. Oh. A potion you found?
I don't want to say no.
A potion you found out right off the bat?
No.
Oh.
I don't want to say what it is, because if he's going to lick it, it's going to sway his judgment.
I'm gonna go ahead and lick it.
It's the drow sleepy time poison. Oh. It's not the love potion. Sorry, no, it's not love potion. It's drow sleepy time potion. I'm not gonna try to rape minotaurs. I wanna see if I can knock them out.
So
you just knock me out? That's rude.
Did you lick it?
Yeah, I licked it, yeah.
Make a constitution saving throw.
I still don't have a DC for it written down.
6.
Yeah, okay, he falls asleep.
Oh, we could probably incapacitate a couple of those with this.
How much do you guys know about minotaurs? Because I don't know.
I know that when they see anything, they get mad and attack it.
I thought that was just red things.
You know, I bet Tree Trunks knows a lot about them, but you just made it pass out.
Yep.
Tree Trunks did not know much about minotaurs.
because this might help, and I cast Disguise Self. Yeah. And I kind of turn my shape into a minotaur.
Okay.
About how tall are minotaurs?
Yeah, I was gonna ask. Does it alter your size as well?
You can go one size larger.
It's 1 foot higher or lower from my height.
You would be a small minotaur.
That's fine, I think.
A baby minotaur.
A baby minotaur.
Do minotaurs even have babies?
Of course, Faustulus.
I'm not really sure how they reproduce. I thought they were just a child of magics.
They're usually generally 10 feet tall.
Holy shit.
Can I try and wake up?
Not yet.
No, we're just gonna leave.
I guess realizing that I shift my shape back and I'm maybe that won't work.
Does anybody have a piece of coal? Maybe in a tinderbox. Does anyone have like a flint and tinder, like a tinder box or like a fire starting box?
Hope.
Damn it. How am I gonna draw dicks on him now?
Rude.
You have a knife.
Oh god, no! I draw the line at mutilation, okay? I'll do some evil things, but I will draw the line at
like
mutilation.
Like shooting a guy who's trying to help you in the head as he's crawling away crying?
Just a little scarification, come on, man.
Yeah, so heal right afterwards.
So what are you guys doing? You guys are standing in this tunnel with the corpse of your victim.
With the casualty.
You guys? Should I put him in the bag?
I don't think he's much use to us.
I don't know if he's any worse off flying on an island, or maybe, you know, in the middle of a road to be eaten by a minotaur, probably.
As I can also turn up to 4 of us visible, so that maybe we could create an ambush.
Or you could wake me up.
Before we go, we will go.
Go.
Yeah, maybe if 4 of us are invisible while we're walking. Wait, how long does that last for?
I can make us invisible for about an hour.
See, I just kind of wish we knew where the traps were, because then we could walk into the traps knowing that
somebody knew where they were.
Yeah.
Us just following Nick's lead. Sorry, guys.
I mean, to be fair, you're also just following what our party does, so it's I'm not even.
Well, he killed something that's been that's caused the death of probably many people.
I followed my heart.
Also, I thought I hated Quebec French, but Abyssal, that's a dirty language. I didn't like the sound of it on his tongue.
Where do you think French stems from?
The Nine Hells? So what are you guys doing?
Do we want to leave the carps? Do we want to put it with us? Do we want to just move on?
We'll just leave the carps.
We should definitely try to move on.
Yes. I'll put 2 silver pieces on his eyes because I feel bad.
I'll pick one of those silver pieces up. He only needs 1.
I'm already walking away. I don't see you do it. I hope you left the one on his bad eye.
So you guys are continuing?
Yep.
Yeah. Won't go for
well,
too much longer
you
here.
All.
We should wake up Tree
Trunks. I don't know. I'm pretty sure we tried doing that before. We couldn't really wake him up. Dumping water. Does anyone want to take a look at his tree trunk while he's asleep?
Oh.
Yeah, maybe carve a couple of pieces.
Not his dick. God damn it. I thought he was naked anyways.
I knew this was going to turn into date rape.
Oh, yeah. Everyone else thought it was too, but just you wait. I got some more things I want you to lick off rocks.
So what do you guys do? Are you waking him up?
Yeah.
Wake him up.
How are you waking him up?
I pour my flask on his face.
Okay. He's wet now.
No, that's a little too chaotic. I don't have any Epsom salts.
I cast light in his face.
Okay. He's still asleep.
I use Druidcraft to make the rankest smelling skunk fart in his nose.
Okay. Still asleep.
I'm gonna take out my cooking pot from the bag of holding. Could you fill this up for me, Treaky? Pretty please.
I pour my flask into it.
Could you try to warm it up a little bit?
<He's good>.
I'll put his hand in it.
Okay.
He's
still asleep.
Don't really have a way to warm it up.
Oh.
Can I use a way to warm it up?
I have my longsword. You could just rest it on that.
Maybe we shouldn't keep live.
I can use prestidigitation to warm it.
Or you can focus on waking me up and trying to get me to piss.
Prestidigitation.
It's warm. He's still asleep.
In warm water. That's my suggestion.
Okay, he's asleep.
Yeah, I always gotta, wake up when my bladder's full. Maybe he'll wake up when his bladder's full.
10 minutes goes by and he's still asleep.
Do you want to just try to drag him? Maybe.
You had to put to sleep the biggest one, right?
I take out my sword and I poke him in the ass.
Okay, he wakes up.
I am going to look around. So I guess that would be investigation.
You quickly dump the water out.
Yeah, it would be investigation.
7.
You're where you were.
Do I see a minotaur?
No.
Okay. So he's no longer cloaked as a minotaur?
He's not.
Okay. That's good.
You were gonna murder Lord Brightwood.
He's gonna try.
Well, what the fuck was that then?
Oh, what do you guys want to do?
Quite the little stone you gave me.
I like getting people stoned on their own accord. But it was a trick used on us by, let's just say some prior captives. Captives.
Then I'm gonna have to keep an eye on you and your rocks. So what have I missed?
Nothing really. Nothing. I only slept for 10 minutes.
Oh. Well then, I suppose let's get going and keep your rocks to yourself.
We should move slowly and be on the lookout for traps.
Do you want a bit of help staying hidden, or do we want to just take it slow? Considering he just found us as we were walking, who's to say some of them might not approach?
Did that sleep count as a minor rest in any sort of way where I
nope.
heal?
What do you guys want to do? You guys been standing here for 30 minutes?
I'm going to...
Do you guys want me to cast Pass Without a Trace so we can move along quietly?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Gosh,
I'm also going to use my Puifui and Stealth in front of everyone.
Okay, everybody roll Stealth.
I'm gonna cast Pass without a trace, and pop my hood as well. Everyone has plus 10 to stealth.
Okay. No real advantage, because we all popping our hoods?
Popping my hood.
Everyone's got a hood now, except Lord Brightwood.
Yeah, but I got a 29 on my stealth.
33.
So the pass the trace is plus 10?
Plus 10, yes.
How long does that last?
Let me look that up. I think it's an hour.
Concentrate. Probably an hour.
Pass without a trace is... Alphabets are hard. Up to
1 hour.
Oh, it's only second level. Okay, I thought it was third.
Cool. Okay, do you guys stealthily walk for the full duration of the hour and still haven't come across any offshoots or anything like that? Are you recasting it?
Yeah, I'm gonna recast it. Yeah. Might as well burn all my spell slots.
Do we have to stealth again, or...?
Yep.
Okay.
Thirty-seven. I guess I should do the bear too.
29.
Wait.
32 on the bear. I gotta stop double clicking everything all the time.
We have advantage.
Bear doesn't. Bear's not wearing
the bear
one.
Doesn't.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you guys walk for another hour and still haven't come up upon anything.
Maybe we should wait until we notice something.
Yeah, maybe.
Plus, it doesn't appear as though we've left any tracks for about 3 hours, so...
So, our trail is fairly well hidden.
Just the markings on the wall that I've left behind.
They have a dead corpse at the start.
So you guys continuing onwards?
Yeah, I'm not gonna recast right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stay ahead of the party and stealth.
Okay, roll stealth.
We're all still stealthing, we just don't have the plus 10 anymore.
Yeah. Okay, we'll keep the same stealth rolls then, that's fine.
Okay.
So you guys walk for like 2 miles before anything comes up.
Can you bend metric, please?
No. You guys get to a point where the tunnel branches off into 7 different tunnels.
Which one does Grant say we should go down?
The third from the left.
Are any of them have, like, an end we can see?
No. Not from where you are.
There doesn't seem to be any, like, ambush or anything set up here.
Make a perception check.
Another one.
Nope.
All right.
I will
walk out into the middle of that area.
Okay. You're in the middle of that area right now.
I can't see anything with my 120 feet of...
What do your elven eyes see?
You see more tunnels.
Okay.
The pyramid guy goes, need more time to calculate. Continue.
Sir Crawl, which way do you think we should go?
Forward. Or I guess we can do a survival check and see which way is the more survivalsome.
Well, let me see if there are any tracks going through any of these tunnels.
Both of you guys can roll survival checks.
Are all the tunnels 13.
26. Exiting
at the same height? Or do some go up, some go down?
They look all identical. There is no change in elevation from what you can see. Sir Crawl, you're having a hard time figuring out which way that you think you should go. Fossilis, you see a lot of Minotaur tracks down all of them. The one, when you're looking at the one that Grant's path is leading down, there is not only Minotaur tracks, but Gnoll tracks.
Convey that to the group.
We've got a raging clue.
Is that the, is that the only one that has Gnoll tracks coming from it?
Yes.
Well, that's probably the one.
What is the quickest quickest route? You'd probably go straight there. What are the chances that any of these other paths might be giving us a sort of side view? Or might they only get us more lost?
Well, you guys do have to find the path up for like 12 more hours, so.
Yeah. Nick, I was making a new mark for side sheets. Guide us back to the hub or something.
Where do you want to go?
Is there any like wind or anything coming through any tunnels?
Because I can hear it.
Make a perception check.
That's definitely why I asked. 13.
Not that you can tell.
Well, does anyone want to search any of these other routes, or... I mean, Shishun did get that very nice little fortress for us to camp in.
It's true.
And, Roland has some shitty... Brightwood has some shitty rusted sword, but... Otherwise, our adventures haven't really brought us much.
Well, they have brought us closer together, and I'm thankful for that.
What do you guys want to do?
You guys want to take the first left path? Just fucking YOLO?
First left path, let's do it.
Sure, might as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you guys walk for a good couple hours, winding through this tunnel, and you come across an area that forks off more into five other paths.
Maybe we should split up.
First left!
No,
we should not split up.
I asked Treaty to mark the path that we came from.
Yeah, I'll make a new mark for offshoots that leads back to the hub.
Okay. Where you go?
First one on the left.
Yeah, let's just go left again.
Okay.
Three lefts make a right. So. Got nothing, let's just go.
So this is a pretty uneventful walk for a good 4 hours or so. And you get to another point that, let me see here. Yeah, you get to another forking place with seven more paths.
It's definitely another one. There's no marks I've left behind.
Make a perception check.
Actually, I'm going to use a different dice because those ones have been shitty today. Oh, that's much better. 23.
Don't see any marks. does, however, look identical to the one you traveled down earlier. Or the fork that you guys went to earlier.
Well, I feel like we're getting off base here.
Yeah, maybe we should just go back to the path.
I'd be okay with that.
And there is a bit of urgency in finding these things for Visirin, because, I mean, we got a demon horde coming after us. Or after the world. So we can't spend all day down here. Or hopefully we won't.
Okay, so where are you guys going?
We're gonna turn around, and when we get to the next hub, take the first right.
Okay.
And then when we get to that hub, take the...
You guys have about 6 hours left on Find the Path.
When we get back to the original 7 hub, I think we're just gonna go down the third to the left path.
Or well, as you guys turn around and begin to walk, Grant... Your Find the Path is telling you you're going the wrong direction.
Oh, okay.
It's pointing down the third from the left path in this fork of 7.
I will convey that to the party. Yeah, we should... It's going this way. Saying this is the shortest path to where we're going.
Fossilis, any tracks?
Can I look around on the... Tracks.
Whatever. Survival checks.
14.
There are tracks in every single one.
There's a whole lot of tracks around. I can't tell ours from the tars to the... I don't have another rhyme.
What sort of tracks?
I couldn't really tell. It was just as if there's a lot of heavy traffic of different
the one to your first through. Left, is the only distinct one. They look like humanoid tracks. Like shoes.
It looks like a couple of people came through there wearing some shoes. Looks like a Nike kick, but... Aside from that, everything just looks like minotaurs. Does it look like there's been a tail dragging through the footprints?
Not that you can tell.
I'm gonna look again for my marks.
Okay.
14.
You don't see any.
Well, Agrico, if it says this way is the quickest way, I'm willing to go that way, but...
I don't know if it's the best way, but it's the quickest.
We may get lost down here. In fact, I feel like we're already gone in a circle.
Well, maybe that's what we get for exploring all the off paths.
Wait.
So Pyramid, follow the...
Is he with us?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, let's go down the... Go down the path that we're being led.
Yep. Let's just go down that path.
Okay. We'll end here in a couple of minutes, but we'll just get to a point here to end. So as you guys travel for about 30, 40 minutes, you guys start to hear the sound of fighting. You can hear howls and yips, along with... a deeper roaring sound.
Do you guys want to be a little bit quiet for this?
Sounds like a good idea.
Alright, I'm gonna pop my last second level spell slot on Pass Without a Trace.
Okay, everybody roll stealth.
Oh, I get to roll twice. Or, yes, twice, right?
Yep. I think you had that fucking advantage there.
Alright.
It's better than that 11.
Okay. You guys are moving forward slowly?
Yep. Oh, I missed the pass without trace.
Okay.
31.
So as you move forward, the sounds of furious battle grow louder. The tunnel ends at a ledge 20 feet above the floor of a large cavern, giving you a perfect view of the conflict below. On the shores of an underground lake, a pack of frenzied gnolls and hyenas surround a demon standing nearly 20 feet tall, with massive arms, clawed hands, cloven hooves, and the head of a bull. This is a Garistro, whose heart Vizrin Devere has instructed you to claim. Leading the gnolls is a figure of fearful countenance, 12 feet tall, with the head of a snarling, amber-eyed hyena. It wields a massive triple flail, whose whirling heads smash into the larger Garistro. The gnolls howl their master's name as he strikes swiftly, again and again. You hear the chants, Yanogu, Yanogu, Yanogu. The larger demon roars, slashing with its bull horns and flailing with its claws, but to no avail. Yanogu evades or shrugs off its attacks, even as gnoll archers pepper it with arrows. Then the gnolls swarm the Garistro as it begins to falter, bringing it crashing to the ground. In less than a minute, the battle is won. The demon lord Yanogu pulls back the Garistro's head by the horns and rips out its throat with its teeth. He throws back his head, and his howl of triumph echoes through the chamber, shaking the stones themselves. Several hyenas nipping at Yanogu's heels leap onto the Garistro's corpse and begin feasting on its flesh. As you watch, these hyenas transform into gnolls. And we'll end there.
Shit!
Alright, so this is your favorite encounter.
Nope.
Oh shit. We're still a dope encounter away.
Let's just say
would have been in the maze.
That a Garistro would be very hard to kill on your own, and this thing just killed it in 1 minute.
Yep.
Didn't even take damage, right?
No.
We can take it.
Yeah. You're in space, Joseph.
We can take it. I have faith.
Yeah, we got this, boys.
There are many other encounters in the maze. You guys just took the roundabout path. But yeah, you guys are ending at watching a Lord of Hell kill a Garistro.
Sure, well, it's a good thing
we need
us...
the probably hidden. We need the Garistro heart, so I don't know.
The gnolls are eating it. We're not gonna get it.
Well, we need it. It'll take a little bit of time to eat through it. I don't know.
We should just run up and take it.
Just firewall it.
Blindsided by a demon lord?
Burn all of them.
I can still turn some of us invisible.
I'm pretty sure that
in darkness.
Demon lords can't handle a tree trunk to the face. This is one weakness.
Yeah, demon lords can't take a lot of wood to the mouth, eh?
Yeah. No, they can't. They can give a lot of wood to the mouth, but they just can't take it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry if I let you guys believe I was gonna love Potion Joseph.
You're gonna be taking so much wood to the face if that was the case.
Oh no, dude. You fall in love with me, which means you gotta have passionate love. We can't just...
Yeah,
fuck.
Which means a lot of wood to your face.
Yeah, very passionate foreplay.
Yeah.
Finding the path was a good call, though, because, that skipped a shitload of encounters. Well, possibly.
Yeah.
You guys could have picked right every time, I guess, but... Yeah. There's a lot of stuff going on in the maze. Like,
yeah.
I said, there's something like 115 encounters or something like that.
Jesus.
Oh, wow.
Christ, had one of them.
Yeah, as soon as, like, we hit level 6 and I got, like, the first I took Sunbeam for a bit, then I'm like, no, we're gonna do the maze, and I've been like keeping it for like the last couple sessions, but god damn it. It's gonna be useful.
We busted out some pretty good things there. True Sight. That was dope. That was cool. I really like that effect. That's gonna have to happen to me again, or
coconuts are mammals because they have hair and produce milk.